Vikings versus the Lions, the Detroit Lions. First play of the game, go.
Action. They'll throw on the move to his left. Completes it to
Let's
Dixon.
Go.
And he'll be taken down, but not before
28 yards.
Across midfield. That's good for 28 yards. So the ball moves into Lions territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 47. Well, they nearly sprung him that time.
Hold
as
it.
He takes us all the way down to the 37.
Yep.
All right, so they got that one, Charles,
he's
against
like,
the center.
You blew the whistle.
Let's remember how difficult it is for the center, because remember, he's got to snap the ball to put the play in motion, and sometimes you got that big guy
no.
on your nose.
And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down.
No.
A loss of four that time on the sack, and it brings up second. Back to throw here. Middle of the field to Jefferson. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work this to the 45. In need of a conversion on third down. They had the big play to start the drive. Not much sense. He'll look to throw. Sliding out of the pocket. Dixon complete.
Thank you.
And all the way inside the 15 before they drop him. That goes for a gain of 31. So how about this for field position after the big play? Inside the 15 now as they come up on first and 10. It's caught on the right side, Williams. And so close, he gets it to the one. Out of bounds right there.
That was close.
First and goal, a chance for an early statement here on the road. Cook is in. Touchdown, Minnesota.
I chose Spike, but he already dropped the ball. You would have to pick the ball back up.
So the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over.
Yeah,
try and
just
kind of drive in the air.
I'm figuring this out.
Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Dixon.
Like my audio situation.
Just short of the 45 at the 44.
Like
took just one play to move all the
Whether
way to
not,
the 44 as they try again on first down.
Do a whole nother series. Kind of new to this.
The play fake. He'll look to throw. They'll roll him out right.
Oh.
And he's able to get this to the 40
Man,
yard
I walked
line
out already.
He's out of bounds.
15's the mic. 15's the mic.
They're going to look to throw. Escaping the pressure right. That is caught. It's Williams. And he'll be marked down at about the 26 yard line.
One of the last plays in this quarter.
Up the middle, it's Cook. And he'll be tackled at the 23 after a gain of 3. And what in the world? Not sure if he just heard a whistle there or what, but for some reason he spiked the football.
Oh, yeah, I did.
On third down, he'll drop to throw. Steps away. Throw left side.
First down.
That's Smith. And it's going to be another first down as
new quarter.
Ground at the Lions 13
whole new play.
Line. These two teams all tied after one. And off comes to Cook. And they'll go backwards here. Losing
Sorry, Cook.
To the 14. They'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11. Back to throw. It's Williams on the catch. And he's going to be marked down just outside the 10. Out of the huddle now for play number 9 on this drive. This is third
Dixon.
Down at 8. They'll drop to throw.
Nope.
And a big loss here.
That was such a bad play.
The defense rising to the challenge and setting him back on the sack. And his kick is indeed good. And they take the lead here now at 10-7.
I saw 100% accuracy.
As mentioned, this one of the hottest teams in the NFL, riding that winning streak into this one. But now playing here on Thursday night.
Whoa, that looks like a face mask.
Helps or hurts their momentum?
But ordinarily, I'd say it hurts the momentum because now you've got that short week. But when a team's playing as well as they are, it actually allows them to down focus and only worry about themselves and less about their opponent. So when you're playing well, You just worry about the things you're doing
dude,
well,
scared.
And let the opponent deal with that.
When in doubt, do it yourself as he keeps it for three and a first down. 2 minutes remaining in the first half, 10-7, our score. Coming up at halftime, I'll go from one personality, that's you, Charles Davis, to another one in Orlando, the coach. He'll have stats and scores from around the NFL. You and Jonathan Coachman, both larger than life.
No doubt about it.
But you're stuck with me in this booth.
That was scary.
And happy.
23 yards on the play.
The 23-yarder.
Signal for the first of their timeouts. As they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next.
I need a drink. No.
Back to throw now on first down. Finding Williams once more, complete. And he'll be tackled on the other side of midfield at the 46-yard line. So, Charles, you talk about this offense, how well they've played. I mean, the defense, too, really. But they're sitting at 10-0 now on the year. 4-0, 5-0, that's nice. But once you start hitting double digits with these wins and no losses, I think
move.
The seriousness of the situation, it just has to ramp up.
Yeah, when you do say 10-0, it can't scare you as a team. Just think about it this way. For most of the year, they've been playing to win their division and get to the playoffs. Now the playoffs are just about a foregone conclusion. So now they have to down focus
Jesus,
their thoughts about getting home field advantage
trucking.
And finishing unbeaten. And they need to make sure they keep it in that order.
Now another timeout called for by the offense as the clock stops here with 46 seconds remaining in the first half. Catch is made here by Irv Smith Jr. And he's taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line.
That was like
a
beautiful pass.
Third and final timeout.
Magically got
caught. And they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. And he will score.
Let's go.
Touchdown, Vikings.
Come on, team. Let's go.
A 10-yard touchdown run. And the Vikings will extend their lead in the... the middle, and he'll work this back to right around the line of scrimmage and surrender there.
Oh,
so we hit halftime.
Halftime report.
The Vikings taking the lead to the locker room as we send you down to Orlando, where Jonathan Coachman has our EA Sports halftime report. Coach,
all right, guys, thanks very much. We'll get back with you shortly, but first, let's take a look at what's coming up this weekend around the NFL. In the 1 o'clock games, the one that catches the eye happens in Big D. At AT&T Stadium, a tough test for the Cowboys as they'll take on the always tough Green Bay Packers. Plenty to like about the late afternoon games as well. As you see by the highlight, these guys are in for a battle, taking on the Atlanta Falcons. And finally, a good one on Monday Night Football between the Chicago Bears and the New York Giants. Meanwhile, in our game, no shortage of offense as each team has been able to move the ball effectively. Will the defenses show up in the second half? To find out, we give it back to our commentators, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Okay, Coach, yeah, adjustments likely going to play a big role in this third quarter in what's been a tight contest so far. This will be fielded inside the five. Now a crease here as he's past the 30.
Ooh. He got some yardage on that. Except that man is to stop him.
Here's Cook as they begin on the ground. And he'll take this ahead for about four. Second down coming up. Following the pickup of four, here's second and six. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. Rolling to his left. He finds his man complete. It's Dixon. And mark him down way up close to the 40 at the 39. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Running off tackle with Cook. And good running there as he'll take this all the way up to midfield.
Outside.
Another good gain. That's now 35 yards combined on those last two plays. From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. Eluding the pressure right. And they'll get him down on the other side of midfield.
This is not a sack.
These two teams, you may remember, they met in Minnesota earlier in the year with the Vikings coming out victorious. So if they can win again here in Detroit, they'd pull off the season sweep. Oh, he bowls over him. And he'll be brought down inside the 40-yard line.
There he goes, and for good reason. Running with it has paid dividends earlier in this game and earlier on this drive. And until they prove they can stop him, I don't think he's going to be shy about continuing to run
instead of airing it out.
And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down, second and right at a yard.
If I can get Williams, but this could be a pass that's going to be incomplete.
Looking to throw, rolling to his right. That'll be complete to Cook. And he'll be marked down at about the 26-yard line.
Close.
Look like defense put pretty good pressure on him, but he's able to flush out to his right to try and evade people. On the run, had to get on his horse. Still accurately throws a nice pass for a first down.
And he maneuvers up the middle for 3, and it's second down. 3 yards on that last carry. Here's 2nd and 7. Again, they'll go on the ground with Whitaker.
I touched my controller when I was sneezing. Oh, no.
This will be a loss of 3, and now a much tougher third down looming.
Yeah.
Come to the line
here,
needing 9 yards
Jesus.
To pick up the first.
Let's go.
That's Dixon. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
That's insane.
One quarter remains here on this Thursday night matchup. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA. And he will take this one into
the
end zone for a Viking touchdown.
Can I tell if I wave? That was swagger.
With his 28. So the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over. Out to his left. Complete. Jefferson the target. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. That's a good way to start the drive. 17 yards and a first down. Again, this is Cook.
Ooh.
And he's going to be hemmed in and brought down right at the line of scrimmage. Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, 2nd and 10.
Oh, no. Oh, wow.
And a big loss here as he's taken down. Multiple defenders getting to him there for a huge loss. Possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is
possibly a turning point.
On the move to his left.
Yep.
And he's gonna go down.
That was a turning point.
The defense rising to the challenge and setting him back on the sack. The Vikings send out their punter as he's on to punt for the first time tonight. He'll take it at the 42. And just a net of 31 here. 40-yard punt, 9 on the return. They start the drive with Cook. And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30.
Alright.
He was brought down
by
Julian Love.
A field goal.
Getting down to the good stuff. All tied with 2 minutes remaining on EA Sports. So the Vikings in possession of the football as we get you reset. Ball on the 30. They'll come up with a 2nd and 5. Now a toss left side into the hands of his tight end. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. It's a gain of 11 as the Vikings pick up the first. A give to Cook out of the gun. Shifts past him at the 45. And this will leave him a yard short.
Nice.
Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down. The previous run good for 9. Here's 2nd and 1 yard. Now a throw from outside the pocket, complete out left. And he'll go down inside the 45 before going out of bounds. They call his number again. It's his 6th catch and a first down.
Okay. So I can run the clock and field goal.
On the ground, it's Cook. And he'll get it down on the play to the 37. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
They know it. I can do this.
They run it again with Cook. And he works it to the 30-yard line here, right at the 30.
The Lions know exactly what I'm doing.
As they get the stoppage with just over a minute to go in the game. Both teams working on short rest, but this has been one of the better Thursday night games we've seen as they come up here on first and 10. And he can only manage to get a couple.
There's a holding.
Second and 8 coming up.
Dang it. I'm at 30.
So that time they got the left guard with a hold.
And let's face it, in today's ball, you might have that 330-pound guy you're supposed to clear out of there. You might need a little bit of extra help by grabbing the jersey and trying to ride him out.
2 yards on the pickup. It'll be second down. They run with Cook. He's been busy tonight. And a solid run down inside the 30. 84 yards on the ground for him now as he has gotten better, really, as the night's gone on. Third down, Dalvin Cook. And he will have the first before he's brought down right on the chalk of the 20. Now here's a timeout as they will indeed call it with 5 seconds to go and a chance with a field goal to win the game. So now this one's going
to
rest on the
field of
their second year kicker. And the clock will now
end
as the timeout is called with 5 seconds left.
Oh my Jesus.
And now this game's going to come down to the right leg of their kicker. He's hit on his one earlier attempt tonight, but this a little more pressure pack for the win. And his kick is good.
Oh my God.
Time on that sideline as they have taken the lead in the final seconds. Well, this one, partner, was fun down to the very end. They
that was scary.
Right before the whistle, then the ensuing kickoff. They were hoping for magic on the other side, but couldn't get that spark.
Fun if you won, and fun for us, because we got to watch it and call it. That magic that you were talking about didn't occur at the end, but what a game all the way through.
So for Minnesota, the perfect season remains intact as they move to 11-0 on the year. And they'll get a few days to savor this one before they take on the Jacksonville Jaguars.
Week 11.
Meanwhile, for Detroit,
won it.
It was a game they really needed as they drop back to 4-6. And they'll have a chance at redemption next week at home against the Indianapolis
Slowly
Colts.
Slowly securing my spot for that Super Bowl.
So for our entire 100%. Crew, alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. Thanks for watching, everybody. We'll see you next time.
GG's. If you guys like that, don't forget to like and subscribe. Thank you for watching. Y'all have a good one. Deuces.